Firstly, we've got to absolutely hammer our joke. Happy birthday to James Acaster. Every time he comes on, it's
thank you very much.
It's your birthday. We've got your special cake.
We thought we'd do it without lighting the candles.
Yeah, didn't want to test that before the live show. What's funny is that you got it. You literally had it backwards. About to set fire to your own body. Best birthday ever.
It's all going so well. Is it? There you go. Happy birthday, James.
Thank you very much.
We'd like you to try some for us. It's delicious.
Oh, I've got braces in.
Have you?
Yeah.
Well, just pretend then.
Well, yeah, I'll just. Real nice cake. Probably like. First of all, Simon set himself on fire, and now I'm pretending to eat it. Yeah. Also, I don't like this new studio.
Why?
I haven't been here since it's moved, and it's used to be in the corner of a shopping centre, and the windows are real, and that's... People probably can't see that at home. That's fake. That's all fake.
No, it's freezing. Not.
I don't like any of this. I don't like any change. Worst birthday of my life.
I didn't even blow his candles out. Can't just blow that one. Thank you. Yeah,
right. I wish for the old studio again.
We don't. We love this new
one. We love this one.
I hate it here. There's personal trainers now.
We'll be talking about music with you later. Do you like 80s music?
Yeah, man. Yeah, I like 80s music. Is that a whole genre now?
Yeah,
I think yeah.
Throw it all together.
I like 80s music, of course. I'm not made of stone, Tim.
James?
Huh?
Has this improved the show for you?
Oh, this is sublime television. What do you like?
I just like a normal building.
It's like a normal building.
I'm just a man of the people, James. Yeah. I'm not like a fancy Dan like him with his
Earl Grey tea.
Yeah. What's that?
I think that you're excluding off of society by saying it's builder's tea. I'm sure other people than builders drink it. If you're not a builder and you drink ordinary English breakfast tea, then I apologise for Tim.
If you're not a builder, you know, like Tim isn't, then maybe don't call it builder's tea.
In my mind, I am.
Yeah, your mind... Oh, yeah, I'm fully aware that in your mind you're a builder. Let's face it, the world at the minute is pretty grim. Everything's like, it's gone to hell. We're all in trouble. It's probably going to end in about 5-10 years, probably, the world. And like, come on, Tim. Pretty soon, you're going to have to change that to a picture of the apocalypse. You're going to have to be doing it here, pretending that everything's okay while someone makes a quiche. And just have fireballs there and Trump riding a dragon.
Because I've tried to listen to albums again. I was listening to a while ago. Yeah, I'm doing that thing. Last night I was listening to your playlist. Yeah. And my temptation was to put it on shuffle.
Sure. But
you know what? I'm not going to do it. I'm just going to let it run.
I was a shuffle guy for years. I would just always put stuff on shuffle, take whatever it is, whatever, like I don't deserve anything better, you know? Do you know what I mean? That's what we've come to now. Oh, just whatever life throws at me, I probably don't deserve anything nicer than that. No. Have a full album and listen to it all the way through and indulge. Put it on, have a glass of wine or whiskey. I like a whiskey, a builder's whiskey. That's my favourite.
Me and the builders.
Good old builder's whiskey.
What have we got coming up?
Pretty good. I'm halfway through a tour at the minute, so I'm in a little break at the moment. Going back on the road in September until December with my show, Cold Lasagna, Hate Myself, 1999.
What's it about?
It's about 2017 being the worst year of my life and why I hated it. There's a little bit in it about 1999 being the best year of my life, but I touched on that pretty briefly. To be fair, a lot of stuff in the title is pretty misleading. Apart from the hate myself bit, there's a lot of hating myself. Oh, don't you worry.
It's pretty... 2017's actually worked out quite well for you, though, because you're making a lot of money out of it, your tour, your book.
Luckily, I'm a comedian and misery is funny, so I'm okay. You know, I was too happy for too long, guys, and finally I had a really bad year and I am reaping the rewards.
James was recently on the Great British Bake Off. How do you feel it went?
Star Baker, I didn't watch the edit, but I presume I won?
Yeah. I think almost
did 100%. Pretty well.
We've got a clip here. We've got a clip.
Yeah.
Can you tell us about your flapjack, please?
Started making it, had a breakdown. Bon appetit.
The reason why I cut the end bit is because actually where it's browned and caramelised with the butter, it's absolutely gorgeous.
Isn't it lovely?
It is. Great flavour, not very well executed.
Story of my life.
Absolutely gorgeous, he said. That's all I heard.
That's what it cuts off at that point.
Yeah, take that quote. Absolutely gorgeous. Hollywood. It's about my flapjacks.
Did you win?
I don't think there's a... Winning doesn't matter when it comes to Bake Off. It's all about the taking part. Yeah. And everyone agrees that we all... Baking was the winner. Baking was the winner at the end of the day. It didn't matter who got the apron.
Who won, though?
Someone...
Just crush the garlic with the back of your hand, chuck the oil in and the cinnamon.
Crush the garlic with the back of my hand?
Yeah, well, with your heel of your hand rather than the back of your hand. There you go.
Like that?
Yeah.
Is that crushed?
Maybe a bit tougher.
How much do I...
Use that bit.
Don't people use actual things for this, like garlic crushers? And you're getting me to use my bare paws, like Tarzan.
How can you not do that?
How can I not...
Careful.
Perfect, there we go, that's beautiful. So that goes in there with the oil and the cinnamon. Oh, and then just shuffle it around with your hands so you get...
No, it's been on the floor!
Some of it slipped on the floor. You're not going to cut that one. You got pre-made stuff.
And then what we do, give your hands a quick wash, and then we cover that and we...
These taps are fake. That's a fake tap. You're living a lie. Back in the shopping centre, the taps weren't fake. Back in the shopping centre, those are real taps. Now look at you. Shells of your former selves. Absolutely disgraceful. Surprised this tea towel's even real.
Is it true that you once stole a cookie from Clint Eastwood?
Yeah, he left it on his table and I ate it, and I really laughed while I ate it because I imagined him saying, go ahead, cookie, make my day before he eats a cookie.
Is that illegal to do, Rob? If someone's left a cookie, you're allowed to just eat it?
No.
What?
Yeah, it's theft.
Is that theft? I broke the law?
You stole a cookie from Clint Eastwood.
But if I were to have something and I just left it in the street, then no one's allowed to take it.
Well, it's theft by finding. It's whether you intend permanently to deprive the person of it, really. And if you're dishonest, that's the test.
Were you going to permanently...
Well, I mean, yes, you wouldn't want it back after you'd eaten it.
Yeah,
I don't know.
He wouldn't want it back off me, would he?
No, back's black.
Well, I'm getting arrested at the end of this show. That's what's happening.
Then you have to squeeze over there so we get rid of some of the moisture.
Oh, this is going to feel horrible. Oh, that feels absolutely gross.
Yeah, we wouldn't have got you to do that at the old studio.
No, back in those days, I'd be squeezing potato pulp in my hands.
We'd have had a potato squeezer.
Absolutely horrible. Oh, the worst moment of my life.
Worst
experience ever. Squeezing that horrible potato. Other people got given knives and stuff. And like, everything I'm doing is with my bare hands, the whole thing. Like Bear Grylls. All the other guys. What's his name? Ray Mears. Remember him?
Yeah, I do. Yeah, he's been on the show. Lovely bloke.
Yeah?
He did the old studio. He was there then.
Oh, he probably still lives there, doesn't he? He's camping there right now as we speak.
Are you going to try this, James?
Nope, not worth it. Not trying it. Got braces in it. I had to clean my teeth and everything after that. Forget about it, mate. Anyone else want some? I'm not touching that.
It's like a hate crime in a glass.
No.
It tastes a little bit like a glass.
I'm not a fan.
Rob can't stop drinking it. Rob started drinking that at the start of the interview and won't stop, and he hates it. every drink, every sip he's going, oh, God. And you love it. Stop.
James reckons he invented the word backsplash, or the words backsplash.
Correct.
Together.
What?
Yeah, I invented the word backsplash. You know, when if you're going for a dump and the water. Yeah.
I'm
what?
So.
You set me up for that, Lovejoy. You have your head in your hands. You didn't know what I was going to say.
I didn't know it was that.
Well, first of all, we've got to say happy birthday to James.
How old am I?
We're not sure it is your birthday, though.
It is my birthday today.
You have more birthdays than the Queen.
Not true.
Let's have a look. These are where everyone celebrates your birthday on our show.
Can I say cheers to James Acaster? It's his birthday. Happy birthday, James Acaster.
Happy birthday, James Acaster.
And happy birthday to friend of the show, James Acaster, as well.
Cheers, James. You sure it's his birthday?
No.
Amazing.
Yeah.
I love
Yeah. We've all had more than one birthday in this room.
But not in the same year.
Good point. What's happening? Why is everybody wishing you a happy birthday on our show?
Because it's my birthday today.
We've got you a cake. Here we go. Do you want to pass over the cake?
Thank you very much. We don't say it so reluctantly.
Happy birthday.
Thank you. We'll have a cake full of unlit candles.
Yeah, and no knife to cut it with.
Very nice. It means a lot to me, guys. Thank you very much.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You're only 12.
12. Well, 12 this year. That's how many birthdays I've had this year.
All right, as well as X Factor being back, today sees the start of the Harvest Festival, a time when people across the UK celebrate the harvesting of crops and local food. Don't they, Simon?
Yeah, they do.
To mark the festival, we want to see...
Sorry, it was a funny interaction. You said the whole thing, they went, don't they? Yes, they do. And that was it. That was all Simon
had
to
say about it. Straight line of Harvest Festival, James.
Trying to hold it.
Straight line.
Maybe laugh. Apologies. Every week I go on Josh's show and just tell a true story. And it wasn't meant to be a regular segment, and it turned into one. And then over the years, got enough. Basically, it's all the bad things that have happened to me. And do you know what, Tim? I'm not happy that it fills a book. But it does. And they're all the times I'm messed up, you know. And that was before Conan. Now, I've already started on another one in my head, because what a life.
But one of the things I want to talk to you about is your thoughts on beavers, cubs and scouts, which really made me laugh. How you're not really that into the names.
Rename them, Tim.
Why?
A beaver does not become a cub in the wild, and a cub does not become a scout. It's completely unrelated to one another, and I think they should pick a species and follow it through logically.
Suggestions?
Change beavers to cubs.
Yeah.
Change cubs to tigers, and change scouts to older tigers. Problem solved. And then, because, to be fair, you know, like tigers, the cubs and scouts are rapidly, they're almost extinct. No one's becoming cubs and scouts anymore. It's not cool. Rebrand it, get the numbers up. Same with same with tigers, actually. Change them to stripy lions. We'll all start saving them again.
There's also a good one where you talk about skydiving. And it does make me laugh. Because skydiving is a beautiful experience for most people. Not for you.
Good for them. If you're in a skydive and it was beautiful, congratulations. Some of us aren't that lucky. Immediately, here's the thing. If you go to a skydive, you're often attached to a professional skydiving instructor, make sure that particular person isn't so jazzed about doing a skydive that it's overwhelming for you to have them on your back. Because the whole time on the way down, he's losing his goddamn mind. Can I say that? He's losing his mind the whole time, really going crazy, going wild. I thought they'd attached another newbie to me. I've never done a skydive before. Well, this must be somebody... And then somewhere else, there's two instructors attached to each other wondering why the other one's not more excited. Absolutely atrocious. Screaming in my ear. And then eventually, because you go in freefall for a minute, and then he pulls the cord and you go straight up like that, and my stomach went haywire, and I had to tell him that I was feeling queasy, and they don't like hearing that. If you tell them you're feeling queasy, especially a guy like him, he threw a sulk. We were still like thousands of feet in the air, and he's sulking in my ear like that. I can hear him just huffing all the time. And then I realised, because already I'm annoyed him, I'm in his bad books, so I didn't tell him that I made the mistake of wearing slip-ons to the skydive, and one of them was beginning to slip off. It was the exact opposite of what I bought it for. I had to hook my toes round so that I was hooking the slip-on on my... I was thinking if this falls off my foot now... Well, for one, I'd be so panicked, I was feeling pretty sick. If I do both at the same time, it's going to look like I've been eating slip-ons. And then complaining that it doesn't agree with me. I'm very panicked in the air. And then when we're coming down, when we're landing, we're supposed to land together. If you do a Scott, you get trained how to land, and you're supposed to both pull this cord and you land and you do that. And he was like, listen, mate, You're not going to be able to do that because you're feeling too poorly, which made me feel like a little baby. You're feeling too poorly. So we're going to have to do an emergency landing. So as we come in, he starts shouting down to people below. Just really loud, he starts going, "We got a sleeper! We got ourselves a sleeper here, people. There's a sleeper coming in." Which I wanted to keep that a secret, personally. I didn't want everyone to know that I was a sleeper. I wanted to, he'd say I'm a tough guy or something. And then we had to skid in. Everyone else did a proper land, and the old sleeper and his angry friend. We had to skid in on our backs, not looking very graceful at all. And then I'm kind of passed out on his, on it, and then someone rushed over and they took a photo of us, which my mum bought for a fiver, by the way. And it's still at our house, and it's just a photo of me passed out, like completely passed out. And he's laying underneath me, looking over at his mates, going, it's like, why is it always me?
How is your cooking, James, at the moment?
I'm a bit rusty, if I'm honest. I haven't cooked in a while. I tried to make a meatballs recently, and it turned into more of a kind of a mustardy spag bowl. It wasn't good. So I haven't got high hopes for this.
Okay.
I'll do my best.
How's the wonderful world of Kettering?
Kettering's doing very well. They're recovering from the mess that happened last year when Lindsay Lohan was going to turn on the Christmas lights.
Yeah.
That's what she said she'd do.
Yes, she did, yeah.
She said when Kettering voted to leave the European Union, she got very angry and she criticised us on Twitter. So Philip Hollobone, who's the Kettering MP, he decided in the few days after Brexit, when he went into, like, you know, House of Lords or whatever, when everyone else was bringing up Brexit stuff, he decided to bring up Lindsay Lohan because that was what the most important thing was at the time. It did us proud, didn't make us look stupid at all. And then he demanded that Lindsay Lohan turn on the Kettering Christmas lights, and she agreed to do it on Twitter, but then they failed to book her because she said, DM me for details, and they were unable to because she didn't follow them back. And that is a pretty baller move from Lohan, just to go, they go, turn on our Christmas lights. Yeah, I will, DM me for details. We can't. Why? Because you don't follow us. Yeah, and remember that and never call me out in public again. Never, ever call me out in public ever again. I'm Lindsay Lohan, you're Kettering. Are you joking? So, they've recovered from that. And they're doing all right.
Oh, we're now joined by award-winning bartender Ryan Chetty. Welcome back to the show.
Thank you.
James is here celebrating his birthday with us.
Cheers.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Thank you very much.
And cheers to Josh Widdicombe. Cheers, Josh.
Cheers, Josh.
Cheers, Josh.
Cheers, Simon. Cheers, Tim. And happy birthday to James Acaster.
A true friend.
Is it quite alcoholic or not? Doesn't really feel it.
That one punches a bit of a...
Oops.
I've just been drinking it like it's juice.
It's your birthday.
Yeah, it's my birthday. That is true, actually. It's my birthday. Drink as much as I like.
Cheers, guys. Cheers to Charlie XCX, who will be performing on next week's show. Cheers, Charlie.
Cheers, Charlie.
Cheers, Tim. Cheers, Simon. Mwah.
Nah. Cheers, Charlie.
No, happy birthday.
Cheers to Jeremy Vine, who will be also be here next week.
Cheers, Jeremy.
Cheers, Tim. Cheers, Simon.
Cheers.
Happy birthday to you too. Too many people don't even care it's my birthday.
I like Simon's the best.
Okay.
As well.
I don't know which one's. Was that yours that I just tried? Or...
No,
I don't
yours.
Know anymore.
That's yours.
We're going to pick a favourite.
That's all.
What a birthday! They're swapping drinks with the lads. We don't know whose is whose. Rack them up!
James, you love your jumper, do you? Do you think jumpers make you funny?
Do jumpers make me funny?
Do they make you funny? That's what we were told.
Someone told you that jumpers make me funny.
No, someone
that
told. Someone told me that you said jumpers.
I said that you said that.
Wow.
Somebody told me that you'd said that James had said.
Yeah.
Well.
God, this suit is hot.
Here's the punchline on your sweater there, though, isn't it?
Very funny nose. I stole this off a boy. outside, so I don't really have any connections with this jumper. But yeah, I just thought I'd wear it, and that makes it hard to know. So I like crossing my arms.
Yeah.
But now I've got this like nose sticking in my elbow every time I do it.
You should have a honkering when you press the nose. You go hum, hum, like that, shouldn't it? Really?
Just keep on poking me, Bill. See what happens. This is why most people, when they have a conversation with someone, don't send someone else ahead to do it first. They get them to come back, tell them what they said, and then try and have the exact same conversation. But the other, you said this to the other guy.
James, you said for comedy, for you, it was one of your greatest years ever, 2016. Is that true?
I was being sarcastic at the time. No. Yeah, but written down, I can see how that comes across as genuine. No, it was wasn't the funniest year ever, was it? But you know, I obviously loved it. You know, I voted Leave and I love Trump, so yeah.
James, you like bees, don't you? You talk about honey.
I do love bees, actually. That is, do you know what? Whoever told you that? That is true. That is true. Yeah, I love bees, mate. I've got like.
It's in your stand up, isn't it?
It's in my stand up, but you know, it's a 20 minute routine. I don't think you can
go. Go on, we might as well. We'll do that. We'll do that a few more songs and then we're out.
Yeah. But yeah, I talk about honey and bees. And it's something I find very interesting. I do find it very interesting. What obstacles do you put in front of the hive to get them? Like one of those horses that.
No, nothing massive. You just sort of a twig over the front, just so they go, oh, that wasn't in front of the front door last night.
A hoop of fire or something.
Yeah, that would be interesting. Really. No, just something relatively.
And James, this is you with, someone. Why have you chosen this person?
Just wanted to say thanks for all his good work this year. Just thought, yeah, give him a Christmas shout out. Worried that his year's been a bit bumpy and wanted to feel real great at the end of it.
Good.
And Robbie.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Amelia. And more from you later on. For all of today's recipes, head to the website, channel4.com/Sunday Brunch. After the break,
Simon, do you know there's a joke on the back of your jumper, James?
Yeah.
Very good. After the break, we'll catch up with Bill and James.
James, you're not a singer. What do you make of his performance?
I'm staying out of it.
Thanks, James. Bill, over to you. Well, if I'd known about your singing, I would have put you on my 3-CD collection of relaxing classics.
Yeah, or my album, I could have done.
Thanks. Amelia, what do you reckon?
I've got my Christmas present sorted out. I just buy your album.
So Amelia knows what she's talking about.
Love something.
Yeah.
Is this traditional that when someone performs something, they sit down with the other guests and everyone says if it was good or not?
Yeah.
Absolutely. Only at Christmas.
Yeah. It seems a little bit extreme and full on. You're handling it very well, by the way.
It rates well on a Saturday night, so we thought we'd bring it to Sunday morning.
That's fair enough.
Yeah, you've got to do it. Absolutely.
You're all drooling. Do you love it? Mm. Yeah. It's fun, isn't it? Will you make it this year? Tomorrow? Yes. Will you make it?
Yeah. Definitely.
100%. You should go for it.
I'll be straight in the kitchen after this.
I think you will.
I will make it. I won't do the suggestion of buy it from the shop. I mean, literally, the whole programme hinges on the fact people shouldn't go and buy their dinners at the shop. And you're bringing that up.
I wasn't going to mention that one.
Next time he's showing you something, just go, can you just buy this from the shop? Everything that gets cooked on it, couldn't they buy it from the shop? Yes, they could. See you later.
Cheers to the table.
Cheers.
Cheers and Merry Christmas to Will Mellor, who'll be joining us on our New Year's Day show next week. Cheers.
Cheers, Will.
Cheers.
Cheers, Will.
Cheers, Tim. Cheers, Simon. I'll see you next week.
Cheers, mate.
Cheers.
That was a guy in a rush,
wasn't it? He went up for doing that, let me tell you.
Yep. Okay. Oh, come on, let's do it then. James, your favourite soup?
Minestrone, please.
Bill.
Desert Island discs.
Tomato and basil, I think.
Oh, yeah. Amelia?
Watercress.
Yeah.
Sophisticated.
Is it?
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Really?
What do you think?
There was no way any of us knew that was a soup.
Don't you think I'm being rude to Amelia? You don't eat onions, do you?
I'm literally really highly allergic to them.
Right, OK. So I was... get away! You stay away from the onions. You stay away from the flames.
Away from the onions.
Health and safety.
James, good?
Yeah, there was a lot of sharp movements around me while I was doing that.
Right, 2016. It's been an amazing year for you again. You were nominated for the Edinburgh Comedy Award for the fifth time.
Yeah.
How did you get on?
Lovely, mate. Yeah, I had a lovely time getting nominated. Always nice to be nominated. It's not about winning.
So you've been nominated 5 years out of five.
Out of six. The first year was an absolute catastrophe. I don't know what happened. And I didn't get nominated. And then the other five I did, yeah. So...
And when are you going to win it? When are you going to win it?
Probably next year. Yeah. Next year I'm going back to my last three shows. So that'll probably up my chances, you know. You do three times as many shows, probably definitely get nominated, definitely win.
Can they nominate you again for shows that they've already seen?
Technically not, but, you know. For this guy, they'll change the rules. Believe you me.
Man, that was funny!
That was so funny.
That was funny.
It's like the first time.
2017, you've got a book coming out. Is that true?
Yes, I am releasing a book in the summer, Tim. It is called James Acaster's Classic Scrapes, and it is true stories. I don't know if you picked up from my descriptions of my shows earlier. They are not autobiographical. When I say I'm an undercover cop and stuff.
Yeah.
But all my true stories are going into this book and are things that have happened to me in my life.
Are they true stories or James Acaster true stories?
They're true stories. They're genuinely, all of it is true. I was very strict with myself that I had to not change anything and keep it all completely fact-based. It's all about weird things that have happened to me, and I think I have just got a new chapter for the book. Once I was interrogated by Santa's security guards. The Christmas Mafia.
Oh, dear. What else have you got coming up in 2017? You're doing your show, you've got a book. Are you ever going to do... Are you going to do any acting? Because we were talking about it before the show.
Sure.
Are you going to start doing some movies?
No plans to do that. No, I did a little bit of acting once in Josh Widdicombe's sitcom, where I basically played Josh Widdicombe's friend, who is... then that's who I am in real life. So I did that. But no one's really coming up to me offering me the big roles. Who do you think I could play?
Yourself.
Myself?
I think
someone has explained to you how acting works.
Yeah.
I don't think you fully Googled acting, have you, before you came here?
I've watched quite a lot of soaps, James.
You've watched a lot of this all themselves. You think it's all just who they are?
Some of them.
Fair enough.
Anyway, thanks, James. Your trilogy. Am I saying that right?
Trilogy is next year. The book.
Yeah.
I've released an album of music. This is how great I am.
That's great. That's definitely my kind of cheese.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Just a little bit.
Some character.
Yeah,
some meatiness.
Stinky.
Thank God.
Stinky cheese.
Oh,
right
it.
Up your nose.
That's wow, that's strong.
I love it. Lovely, that.
That's really strong.
Beautiful, isn't it? No, do you not like that?
We can't breathe on each other now.
Are you all right, James?
I've got my own phone here. I'm really enjoying it.
I'm not bothered if you're not.
James, can you just take a piece of cheese and pass it on the blue cheese?
So finally, we've got a gorgonzola. So,
gorgonzola.
And again, now we've got same
cheese.
So
that's
what are we looking for with the gorgonzola?
Picante one, this one.
That's the
picante. That's the aged version of gorgonzola.
The marmalade
80
with it.
80 days maturation. Have a try with this one. This is cracking. Orange marmalade.
This is the king of cheeses, this.
Orange marmalade and gorgonzola is beautiful.
Just put it on the cheese.
Yeah, go for it. Not too much.
I've done too much, haven't I?
That's fine. I mean, you'll deal with it. But this is great.
That's great.
Oh! All good.
The only thing is, don't have that with Weetabix.
No, wait a minute. Yeah.